In this video, we are going to look at two ways to fracture objects. One will use dynamic fracturing from a whole object, while the second will use pre-fracturing held together by a glued network. So here we have a basic torus, we're just going to copy and paste it, and then turn off visibility on one of them. Hit the L key to organize your nodes, and we're going to turn the torus into a rigid body object. We're also going to make a ground plane to drop the torus on. Now let's just turn off grid and ground plane visibility. And before we hit play, turn on real-time playback. You can press the up arrow key to play and stop the playback. Alright, so our torus drops, now we just need to shatter it into pieces. Select the torus, and then we're going to click on Make Breakable. Press Enter to complete the operation, and then go back up to object level, and we'll hit play. Cool, we have a fracture. Let's go into the AutoDoc network, and in the Voronoi Fracture Configure Object node, change the max fractures to 2. Also, make note of the impact radius parameter. You can use this to control the diameter of shatter of your object, so for example, a small localized area, or your entire surface. Now we're going to play it back. So now you can see that we have a secondary fracture after the initial one. Let's go back up to object level, hide this torus, and then we'll reveal the second one. Select the torus, and then go to the model shelf set, and click on Shatter. Click on the Chunk Centers node, and set the force total count to 40. Go back up to object level, and select the torus, and click on RBD Fracture, and keep it set to RBD Packed Object. We're just going to turn on Wireframe Unshaded, and then hit Play. Now we are going to apply a glue constraint to the torus so that we can tweak the amount of shatter on it. Click on Glue Adjacent, and then press the Enter key to complete the operation. Now we're going to play it back, so you can see that we didn't get any shatter. Let's go into the Glue Constraint node, and we're going to change the glue strength because it's too high and it's keeping our torus from shattering. We're going to play it back, and now you can see that our glue strength is too low and is allowing for a complete shatter. So let's put it somewhere in the middle. That looks about right because we have a partial shatter where we still maintain the bulk of the shape and we're still getting some chunks. Go back up to object level and make a sphere big enough to catch both tori to shatter on. Now we just need to turn the sphere into a static object and then we're good to go. Let's play it back to see what we get. So the torus on the right didn't really shatter, let's move it up a bit. And we're going to hit play again. And now we have a shatter on both tori. And these are just some examples of how to shatter objects inside Houdini.